Trying to compare too many numbers at once can quickly become overwhelming and meaningless. Look at this line chart. The values in that data set are all so close together that we barely see anything. Small multiples allows you to create clear and easy to read charts. In this video tutorial, we are going to reduce clutter in busy line charts by plotting your data in small multiple charts. Small multiples are several graphs, all on the same scale, arranged together. In this data table, we have the average rainfall of 5 countries per year. To construct the small multiples, we will create 5 separate line graphs, one for each country. Let's create the first line chart. Highlight the data from A1 to E2. From Insert tab, click the line chart. Make it smaller and move it somewhere here. This is the first line chart for Italy. In a small multiple series, the axes need to be the same, so we need to revise the scale of the y-axis to cover the mean and max average rainfall of all the countries. Right-click the y-axis and click Format Axis. Now, right-click on status bar and enable minimum and maximum value. Minimum is 715 and maximum is 1860. So change the mean bound to 400 and max bound to 2000. The next step is to copy the chart and paste it somewhere here. Move the chart beside the first one. Right-click on the second graph and choose Select Data. Click the Edit button and then use the cell picker icons to point the graph onto the next set of data for United States. Click OK and OK again. Delete that axis. And repeat the same steps for each of the countries. Make sure all the graphs have the same sized plot area, including the first one on the left, which houses the axis. Let's select all graphs by holding down the Shift key and clicking on them all. Then look in the Drawing Tools tab and under the Align button, select Align Top. You can also remove the outline of each chart. Finally, remove the Excel grid lines. Small multiples of line chart make it easier to compare values. I want to thank you for watching this lesson, and I will see you in the next lecture. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you want to improve your skills, consider subscribing. Don't forget to hit that bell, so you don't miss out when I put out new videos here. Thank you again.